Mr. Vincent. I'm gonna ask you a few questions. Do you know why you're here? Do you, Mr. Vincent, confess that you are guilty of your actions? Mr. Vincent, you do realize that no matter what you do, our system will break you. We will find all of your followers, and we will do whatever it takes to keep our world in order.
If you have faith as small as a mustard seed, we can say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move. Do you believe in faith, man?
I believe in facts, and the fact is that I'm the one asking the questions here.
Well, I believe in faith. I believe that faith is a strength by which the shadowed world shall merge into the light.
The world has changed, technology has advanced, and our nation is at peace. But it has always felt like something was missing, even though we had so much, and never felt the gap inside us. That's when I came upon God and felt the gap begin to fill. But in order to keep our nation at peace, Project 451 came into being, a law that stayed all religious practice banned in order to keep us from thinking differently. I kept my practice in secret and hope one day God will work through another like myself. Who knew that day would actually come?
Need to ask a question.
No one ever asks the teacher for questions. Just email him.
Don't worry, it'll be fine.
Oh, can I help you?
I've been trying to write a research paper about how the world is better than it used to be. And after reading about how the world used to be and how it is today, why did the world change? Why did believing in all those religions become bad all of a sudden? And why did all those religions disappear?
Young man, please come with me.
But it was just a question.
Class, I'm taking Mr. McCollum to the principal office. The bell's about to ring any minute. Carry on.
What are you doing? It was just a question.
Do you want to go to jail? You're not allowed to ask questions in school. Only through email where they can supervise you, especially questions about our history. In every classroom, they monitor so they can control kids like you.
Then why are we speaking in here?
Because there's no ears, only ours.
Then why don't you just answer my question?
You know I can't.
I'm pretty sure that the principal would love to hear about a room where you can talk about anything freely.
All right, fine.
Why don't you just tell me the truth?
The truth? How about I show you the truth? But the truth has a cost.
Well, okay, sure. I won't tell anybody.
There has been others who have shared this information.
Well, what happened to them?
They were captured, taken in, and questioned. When they try to get every bit of information out of you. But everyone acts like they never exist when they disappear, because they're afraid.
Afraid of what?
An organization that finds people who go against the law and erase them from society.
A Bible? Isn't this forbidden? How do you have it?
Let's just say that I went looking for answers, and I found them all in there. Today when you ask me, why are the things the way they are today? I knew I had to share this with you.
It was just a question.
No. I believe this is a sign from God.
God? Isn't this illegal?
Yes, it is illegal. But that is the cost. Come by tomorrow, and I'll teach you.
How will this show me the truth?
It won't just show you the truth. It'll change your life forever. That Bible is one of the last ones in the world. The chance you ever see one is one in a million.
Then I'm in.
This is a last resort. If something happens to me where you feel like you have nothing left to live for, open this letter. Don't tell anyone about this. Tomorrow, your life changes forever.
All right, thanks. I'm home.
Matthew, you're late again. What have you been up to?
There's some leftovers in the fridge if you're hungry.
All right,
thanks. Honey, remember we have counseling tomorrow at noon.
I can't make it. I have plans.
John, you know you can't skip out on these classes if you want things to work out.
I said I can't make it. Can we go next week?
Plans are more important than our marriage? I'm tired of this, John. If you want things to work out, then we need to attend these classes.
Mom, wait. You're just gonna leave?
I can't take this anymore, Matthew. I'm only gonna be gone for a couple of days.
But what about me?
Just shut up! Just go do your studies.
Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man separate.
What did you say?
Nothing.
Anything you do or say can be used against you in the court of law.
Excuse me, young sir, but who are you?
I'm Matt.
You do realize you're late.
Oh yeah, I slept in.
Well, kids will be kids. Do you know why we're arresting your professor?
No, I don't.
Well, a student was walking by Mr. Vincent's office and heard him talking about God. To a student. Do you by chance have any idea?
I don't know who it could be.
Attorney Liberty, we should go now.
Take this criminal to Chief Mercy. We'll use force to get answers.
Matt, are you okay?
I don't know. I don't know what to do.
Well, remember that I'm always here.
Hello, kids. Right, my name is Mr. Rogers, and I'll be taking over Mr. Vincent for the time being. And so, if you want your answers, so please scroll to page 38 and read a 2-page essay about why.
I believe that faith is a strength by which a shattered world shall merge into the light.
How can a man like you have faith at a time like this? You've heard the stories. People like you are cut and erased from this world. You don't even have a wife. No one will miss you and no one will remember you. You're nothing but a teacher, a nobody.
It doesn't matter if I remember or not, as long as I continue to spread his word.
Whether or not you find one, it's already too late. God is working in us. We reap what we sow. I have planted a seed of faith into one already, whose faith grows every second. Faith, the size of a mustard seed, already moves mountains. What do you expect next? God will return to our shattered world and put the peace back together. All we must do is seek redemption and believe.
Matthew, what are you doing here?
I need to tell you something.